Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Jessica and today is our Christmas art swap. So I have talked about the collaboration in a previous video, which I will link on the screen if you want to go hear about that. We have decided to a Christmas themed artwork because our Christmases are very different. She lives in Australia and I live in New York in the United States. So I wanted to create this piece for her to show her kind of like what a typical or cliche New York Christmas is like. So right now outside, I have about a foot and a half of snow and it is 18 degrees Fahrenheit. So it is very cold. I wanted to make this art for her so that way it was like her looking into a Christmas or a Christmas up here. So it's a little hard to tell right now, but this is basically a scene in a house. And it's viewed through a window that's covered with some snow. So you're looking into this snow-covered window to a warm fireplace with some stockings that get hung. And that fireplace is covered with some garland. And then the chimney has a wreath hanging on it. And I placed a comfy chair over to the right. And we have the big Christmas tree over to the left. And I love Christmas trees. I want a really big one right now. Ours is about 5 or 6 feet, so it's about as tall as I am. But I love like really big trees, like 8 or 9 feet that like go from floor to ceiling. So underneath the tree, I painted a couple presents on a rug. And then at the very bottom of a picture, I have a little table. And on the table is a plate of chocolate chip cookies, a glass of milk, and a plate with celery and carrots. So some fresh vegetables. So the story here in the north, I mean, I don't know what stories, you know, are told by you or where you're from, but we have this thing that kids put out a plate of chocolate chip cookies for Santa with a glass of milk when he comes on Christmas Eve, and you leave some celery and carrots for him to take for his reindeer. And I actually did this as a kid, you know, when I believed in Santa, and my parents would, you know, eat part of the cookies and leave like crumbs on the plate, and then they would write this really pretty letter with like fancy handwriting and colored pencils or whatever they use, and it was just like, I don't know, it just seemed like extra special. I don't actually have a fireplace. My husband's parents do, and they actually hang their stockings in front of it. It's not an open fireplace. It has a glass, I don't know how to explain it. It's like behind glass, but it's real fire. But they hang their stockings, and those are filled with little presents or candy or little goodies, and those usually get open first on Christmas Day. So we'll go through our stockings first and then we'll, you know, divide our presents up into piles next to each other for whose gifts, and then we take turns opening one gift at a time and we watch, and sometimes we pass things around, so it's really nice. I actually brought out my gold acrylic paint because I wanted to add like a little shimmery, like magical touch to the painting. And I painted some garland around the tree and I painted a gold star. I also do a couple of gold ornaments on the tree. I put gold ribbon around the presents and some gold dots into the garland, which could be like lights or ornaments. But I just wanted a little shimmery extra special touch. And I'm pretty proud of myself with this piece because this is probably the most detailed piece I've done in a while. And I think interiors are very hard to do. So it probably looks like a simple interior, but to me, this is the most complex interior I've ever drawn or painted. So now I started to do the snow, and I started to do it blue, which seems fine at first, but after I painted the whole thing with the blue and I let it sit for a day, I realized it was a very big contrast. I didn't like the way it looked, and snow is not blue, snow is white, and I just didn't want to leave all this white space because then it looked unfinished. So after a while I thought about it, and what I decided to do was around the edges of the painting I used my black watercolor, so that way it was kind of like nighttime and it, you know, the picture kind of fades off into the night. And then I painted over the snow, the blue snow, with the white, it's called Chinese white paint, but it's very similar to white gouache. It's opaque in the fact that it kind of covers up what's underneath. I put some of that white paint onto my paintbrush and I flicked it onto the finished piece, so that way it gives the effect of it's snowing in a snow-covered window, and that all the way from sunny Australia, she is looking through this cold winter window into a New York Christmas. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this piece and enjoyed listening to what Christmas is like for me. So now I encourage you to head over to Emma's channel so you can check out her artwork that she had sent me, and I'll leave a link to her channel in the description below. I also encourage you to enter my giveaway. I'll leave a link below as well, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!